We've been in a very long cycle this time where we've had an expansion since June of 2009 in the economy, and we've had a recovery in equity markets, longest ever on record, right? Longest and yet weakest as well. So this is all very significant. The reason that we've able, that the system or the cycle was sustained several years longer than the average this time was because of all the really aggressive intervention from central banks all over the world, which added to global credit. You know, we came into a financial crisis that everyone acknowledged was caused by too much debt. And the solution that came after was to add about 60% more debt to the world. And I find there's a lot of skipping over the foundational aspects, like whether the person should have risk products at all, whether they should pay off debt first before they even start trying to buy mutual funds or stocks or whatever the product is that's, but because the industry primarily earns its money by when people put their cash into these products, there's really a big incentive or focus on that as the end result. I'll often ask people, okay, if you tell me how much money you would take to the casino this weekend, and what would you be comfortable wagering? Most people will say, oh gosh, $50, $500, $1,000. Okay, but you've got the bulk of your savings in this casino that you don't even understand what the rules are, what the timeline is, what the goals are, when you're gonna take your funds and go. I call it jumping out of moving vehicles, right? You could say, I'm gonna stay and I'm gonna go from A to B in this vehicle. But the reality is that when things start going really terrifying, when you start to doubt the driver because you think, well, you know, this is crazy, we're out of control here, we're, you know, I'm afraid, I'm losing sleep. Those things are legitimate responses. And what happens is people panic and jump out. You have to be the most afraid of losing principal. And this whole mantra about you're afraid of missing out, that's a fool's errand, because once you get into that afraid of missing out stuff, you have no personal discipline. You don't, you know, you're racing in a race that you may not even want to be in, or next to people that are incredibly reckless or don't know where they're heading, and you're just running with the crowd because they're running. And it goes back to organizing your platform so that you're not, you know, at the whim of the wild and woolly markets, and so that means, you know, you should focus on things like your health and education are foundational. It sounds boring, but it's true.